fantastic. Thank you for coming.
Thank you. You're so nice. I love coming.
Did you get to meet David Hasselhoff?
I didn't. He just whizzed by me in the back.
It's funny because I thought he was imaginary until tonight, but it turns out he's very, very real.
No, I saw him and I heard him. He's full of life.
He's the Hop. He definitely is. There's no one else is the Hop. That I know for sure.
Absolutely.
You did a triathlon, I know, because you seem to be in fantastic shape.
Thank you. Yeah, I had a week off of shooting. We had a little break, and I had never done one, and I decided to join the Malibu Triathlon. And I had a new bike that I had never used, and so I wanted to try my bike out.
A triathlon is running, biking, and water slide, right?
It's a half-mile swim in the ocean, an 18-mile bike ride, and a 5-mile run. And I just figured, woo, let's
yeah,
do it.
Yeah. And that's just in during your off week?
Yeah, I had an off week, and my friend...
Isn't that less than people would normally train for a triathlon?
Well, I wondered how people ever got involved in those things. I always heard about them, but I didn't really know how people got into them. And so I just called my friend Gunnar Peterson, who trains Jennifer Lopez, because I'd heard that she was doing it. And I said, how do I get in? I want to try. So he pulled some strings and sent me a wetsuit and said, come show up on Saturday and see how you do.
So Gunnar sent you a wetsuit, and then you were in.
Yeah.
And how did you do?
I came in third. I got the bronze.
That's very good.
And I had no...
It's humiliating for those who train for months to prepare for it, but...
Well, yeah. Well, J-Lo Jennifer had had two babies, and she had been training quite a bit, I think.
And how did she do?
She came in fifth.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but she was the one that told me that I had come in third. There was a free waffle tent afterwards if you did the triathlon.
That's where I would have been.
Totally, right? I was running to the waffles. I was swimming, biking to the waffle tent. And so I was in the waffle tent with my friend after eating waffles, and she came in wearing a medal. And I was like, wow, Jennifer, that's great. You did good. And she was like, Eliza, what are you doing? I said, I'm eating waffles. She said, well, Cindy Crawford's been out there calling your name for 15 minutes. You got the bronze. Go get your medal, stupid.
Really?
So I went out and, yeah, I had waffles in my...
And which was better, the waffles or the medal that you received from Cindy Crawford?
It was like, I guess it was the waffles.
The waffles, of course. Well, waffles are delicious.
I'm really proud of my bronze, though, because I wasn't very athletic in high school, and no, it was kind of nice to sort of be that girl.
Last time you were here, you are kind of a sportswoman, rather.
Yes.
Last time you were here, PETA, the lunatic organization that, they're animal rights activists, they were upset because you talked about hunting with a bow.
Well, we were doing target practice when I was here.
Yeah.
We were shooting arrows into bales of hay, and they got... I heard they got upset.
Yeah, they love hay and they want to protect it. They did because I guess I don't know why, because you would eat the animals if you shot them. And people, I guess it's better to have someone else kill the animal for you rather than kill it yourself.
The arguments that they choose.
What did
they
say about
you? Oh, they had beef. beef with me.
Yeah.
They compared me to Dahmer, which was a little aggressive,
I thought. Dahmer?
Jeffrey.
Jeffrey, that one, yeah. Did they compare you favorably?
I guess anyone that eats meat is that way. I don't know. I mean, I thought it was a little excessive, but I think that, you know, if I'm going to eat meat, I'd like to go fishing and eat what I fish, and same.
Well, there you go. There you go. For instance, I'm planning to hunt and eat Guillermo eventually when I... when my use for him is done. Now, you, this show, Dollhouse, which is a great show, I've watched it a number of times, and it's a very... Here's the thing about the show, is your memory gets erased at the end of every show, so so each time, you're your body, but you're like a different character every single episode.
Yes.
And that's
so
got
I play like sometimes 3-4 different characters every show, which is fun for me, because I sort of have multiple personalities.
There's a lot of killing, and there's a lot of fighting and all that sort of thing.
Sometimes. This Friday is a really cool episode, though. I play, there's like a Waco cult, and they send me into a cult compound, but they implant cameras into my eyeballs so that they team up with the FBI, or a senator kind of goes to the dollhouse and hires us because he wants to get reelected. And they put cameras in my eyes and send me in as this blind, you know, true believer. So I'm actually playing a woman that is trying to join this cult, but I'm playing blind and they see everything through my eyes. It's really kind of
That's what
awesome.
They did to the guy on American Idol.
show. I haven't watched American
That's what
Idol.
Fox does. They do that sort of thing.
I haven't watched American Idol.
Well, yeah, there's a blind contestant, but we have a clip here from the show. If you haven't seen it, it's Dollhouse, Friday nights at 9 on Fox.
Dollhouse is real.
Yeah, remember that, PETA. Eliza Dushku, everybody. Dollhouse Fridays at 9 on Fox. We'll be right back with Pendulum.